Assalamu alaikum students, hope so you all will be fine. The next topic that we are going to start is the structure of kidney. Okay students, when we talk about the structure of the kidney, in this topic we will learn about the size, position and the things that protect the kidney. The first thing that we are going to discuss is the color and the shape of the kidney. As you can see that when we talk about the color and shape, the color of the kidney is dark red and it is bean shaped. And when we talk about the size, the kidney is 10 cm long and it is 5 cm wide and 4 cm thick and its weight is 20 grams. And when we talk about the position of the kidney, it is present against back wall of abdominal cavity, below diaphragm, on each side of the vertebral column. This is the position of the kidney. As you can see in the diagram, this is the back wall of the abdominal cavity and it is present below the diaphragm, and the third thing, on the both side of the vertebral column. And the thing that protect the kidney is the last two ribs of your body. From the rib cage, the last two ribs protect the kidney. This is the structure of the kidney and the basic things that I have told you about the kidney. And now we will learn about the internal structure of the kidney. Okay students, when we talk about the internal structure of the kidney, the first thing that we are going to discuss is the concave shape of the kidney. This is the concave shape of the kidney and it faces the vertebral column. Suppose that this is your vertebral column and this concave shape faces the vertebral column, and here is the depression like this. As you can see over here, this is a depression and it is toward the vertebral column. And what is the name of this depression? This is called as hilus. This depression is called as hilus, and this is the place from where the ureter leaves the kidney, and blood vessels, lymphatic vessels and nerves enter the kidney and also leave the kidney. This is the place, hilus is the place through which all these things occur. Okay student, this is the first part of the internal structure, and now we are going to discuss the internal structure of the longitudinal structure section of the kidney. What happened in the longitudinal section of the kidney? It is divided into two regions. As you can see, these are the two regions. This is the outer region and this is the inner region. The outer region is called as the renal cortex, and the inner region, this is called as the renal medulla. When we talk about the outer part of the kidney, the outer region is dark red. As you can see this part, this is the outer part and this is dark red in color, and we call this is renal cortex. And when we talk about the inner part, this is the inner part of the kidney, and the color of this part is the pale red, and we call this is renal medulla. The inner part is called renal medulla and the outer part is called as renal cortex. Alright students, when we talk about the inner part of the kidney, it also consists of some cone-shaped areas. These are the cone-shaped areas. And we call these are the renal pyramids. We call these cone-shaped area the renal pyramids because they are of the shape of the pyramid. That's why they are called as the renal pyramid. Remember one thing students, when we talk about the kidney, the renal word is always used for the kidney. So as you can see that when we talk about the cortex, we have used the word renal cortex. And when we talk about the medulla, it is renal medulla, and these are the renal pyramids and they are cone-shaped structures, and they are projected into the funnel-shaped cavity. As you can see that in this cone, it is projected into the funnel shaped cavity, and this is called as renal pelvis. We called this is the renal pelvis, and it is also the base of the ureter. As you can see that this structure, these are the renal pelvis, and after that they are changed into the ureter. So we will say that this is the base of the ureter. Hope so it will be clear to you, and thank you so much.